The system's development lifecycle is a series of well-defined phases performed in a sequence that serves as a framework for developing a system or a project. The planning phase is one of the most critical phases of the SDLC model. The problem can be identified internally or externally. Here's some questions to ask. Why is the information system being developed? Who are the system's current and future users? Is the system new, or is it an upgrade or extension of an existing system? And which functional areas will be using the system? Establishing evaluation criteria ensures objectivity throughout the SDLC process. In addition, analysts must get feedback from users on the problem and the need for an information system. The end result of this phase will give users and top management a clear view of what the problem is and how the information system will solve the problem. To ensure an information system's success, users must have input in the planning, requirements gathering and analysis, design and implementation phases. System designers and analysts should explain the goals and benefits of the new system so that the task force knows what to look for in user input. Internal users are employees who will use the system regularly, and they can offer important feedback on the system's strengths and weaknesses. External users are not employees, but do use the system. They include customers, contractors, suppliers, and other business partners. Although external users are not normally part of a task force, their input is essential. Using a task force for designing an information system is similar to using the joint application design approach. Feasibility is the measure of how beneficial or practical an information system will be to an organization. It should be measured continuously and throughout the SDLC process. During the planning phase, analysts investigate a proposed solution's feasibility and determine how to best present the solution to management in order to obtain funding. To conduct an economic feasibility study, the systems analyst team must identify all costs and benefits, tangible and intangible, of the proposed system. Opportunity costs measure what you would miss by not having a system or feature. Technical feasibility is concerned with the technology that would be used in the system. Operational feasibility is the measure of how well the proposed solution will work in the organization and how internal and external customers will react to it. Scheduling feasibility is concerned with whether the new system can be completed on time. Legal feasibility is concerned with legal issues.